When Dr. Lang saw these patterns, he said, "I don't recall seeing something like this before. I was speechless."
This is really the first time where we've discovered in our work a new origami pattern that we're not taking from the origami community.
We identified a category or family of origami patterns called the bloom pattern.
The bloom pattern is a class of origami patterns we can apply in engineering to do new things we haven't been able to do before. It's also some really beautiful shapes that are visually stunning.
The student, Kelvin, he's developed, has investigated an entirely new family of origami patterns that he's called bloom patterns, that allows one to construct really an uncountable infinity of new types of patterns.
This is an example of a bloom pattern. It has some unique properties. This rotationally symmetric, it'll look the same from any angle that you're looking at it, and then comes in as flat in another state.
Everything, no matter how big it gets at the end, collapses into stacked layers above a flat disk. And that's really powerful.
It can be stowed as a compact disk and then deployed into a large array.
That's especially useful for things like space structures where the packing is extremely important.
To demonstrate the scalability of bloom patterns, we adapted the design of the 3D printed bloom pattern, one that is 1 meter in diameter and that has acrylic panels and plastic membrane backing.
Watch everybody else's hands and try to stay level. 3, 2, 1.
The large model folded successfully the first time. So it shows an engineering approach when you make smaller downscale prototypes and iterate over better designs before you finalize and make a larger design that scales but works.
We apply origami-based engineering to do deployable systems, things that can be small in one state and then be big in another state. So this new pattern has a lot of potential in space, but it comes around in a circular pattern, and also the panels are all the same.
And for manufacturing, that's nice because you could just, if you're making a solar array, you could stamp out 100 identical triangles.
It has the potential of dramatically reducing the cost and the time to make. This is made out of PET, which is the same material you may use to make water bottles out of.
It is stiff enough to hold water, and that means we can have these deployable containers stacked together in a cylinder. So we've made bloom patterns out of paper, PET, Tyvek, aluminum, and also 3D printed bloom pattern. And it just demonstrates how we can make bloom patterns out of different materials and different manufacturing techniques.
We've opened a door into a new family of patterns. And we can now go explore through that door. There's a lot of patterns out there waiting to be discovered.
It's not just the engineering behind it, but it's also a new class of origami patterns. And that's just cool.
I love to do origami, but if I can use origami to make practical applications that benefit the world, that will be a dream come true.